Hello, thank you for the great introduction. I'm used to walking on stage to applause, so perhaps I'll create my own. There we go. So my name's Darren Delaney. I am a magician. I used to perform at live events. I've been doing this from my house for the last year. Completely bonkers, I know. Denise, who we mentioned, will be joining me earlier. But first of all, I've got something that all of you can join in with, whether you've got your cameras on or not. But I can see all of you that do have your cameras on. So please do follow along. I am watching you. You'll need both hands, though. So if you've got a drink in your hand or something else, just pop it down for the moment. And point the first finger of each hand up towards the ceiling, like so. Very good. You weren't expecting this this evening, were you? Take your left finger, move it across your face and place it on the right side of your nose. Excellent stuff. With your right finger forming a cross, place it on the left side of your nose. A couple of people look confused, but I think most of you are with me. Take a deep breath in. Breathe out. And then very slowly, copy me.
Oh.
This is going to be a lot easier than I thought. I can see already. I'm just messing with you. I'm sorry. I'm such a bad person. But I know, West London Business Awards, you're all a very smart crowd of people. And you're probably thinking, come on, Darren, it's not actually magic, is it? It's just tricks. So rather than insult your intelligence, I thought I'd share with you how some of the magic works before we get on with the rest of the show. And I'm going to do a classic of magic to do this. I'm going to do a trick where I take a newspaper, tear it up into little pieces, and then put the pieces back together again. But I will explain exactly how I do it as I do that. Now, to do this, I'm going to use a copy of the Daily Mail, just because I really enjoy tearing it up. Sorry if there are any readers watching. And I've got a couple of pages. This is from earlier this week, and I'm going to explain how this works. So to most of you, it will appear that I am tearing the newspaper in half. The secret is, this is just an illusion, and I'm not really tearing it up at all. Now, a lot of people think they can't only see me tearing the newspaper, but they can also hear the sound of newspaper being torn. But I assure you, this is just an illusion, and I'm not really tearing it up at all. Some people think they can't only see the newspaper being torn, they can't only hear the sound of newspaper being torn, but they can also see the individual pieces of the newspaper apparently getting smaller and smaller. But I assure you, this is just an illusion, and I haven't torn up the newspaper at all. Thank you. I'm sensing doubt. Hang on a sec. And there we go. As promised, the newspaper was never destroyed. Do you know, I have another show tomorrow evening. I can just reuse this. This is environmentally friendly magic. That's what we're all about. I'm sensing you're not buying my explanation, though, so we'll get rid of that. I think it's time we're going to welcome Denise to the stage to help me out. So, Denise, hopefully you should appear on my screen just up here. Hello, how are you?
Good, thank you. Very well. Yourself?
Very well, yeah. Whereabouts are you watching from?
Chiswick.
Chiswick? Oh, not too far. Yeah. So I'm in southeast London, you're just in southwest. Now, just to be clear before we kick this off, you have been picked at random, but we haven't spoken or communicated before just now. Is that correct?
We have not.
Excellent. We're gonna play a little game, Denise. Very simple game. You should be familiar with it. We're going to play a game of noughts and crosses, or tic-tac-toe, if there are any North Americans amongst you. Noughts and crosses here in the UK. But before we do, I wanted to know how many different ways you could play a game of noughts and crosses, and the answer blew my mind. It's over a quarter of a million, apparently. There are 255,168 possible outcomes in a game of noughts and crosses, and we're going to create one of those together, Denise. It's going to be you against me. Now, just in case you're not familiar with the rules, the idea is to get a row of noughts or crosses horizontally, vertically or diagonally before the other player does. The only other rule that I'm going to add is I get to go first, as it's my game. Give myself some kind of advantage. So I'll go just here. So Denise, now think carefully, because where you place the first cross will dictate how the rest of the game goes. So you've got top left, top middle, top right, middle left, middle right, bottom left, bottom middle, or bottom right. Where would you like to place the first cross.
Bottom left, please.
Bottom left, so that's left as we look at the grid, yes? Are you happy with that?
Yeah.
Yeah, excellent stuff. So now we have a game, so I'm going to go with the next one. I will go just about there. And where would you like to place the next one?
Below, middle, bottom.
Middle, bottom, yes. It would be a shame to let me win that early in the game. I will go bottom right, just over here. And the next cross?
I will go middle left, please.
Middle left, just, I can see, sorry, I'm looking at the screen of all of the rest of the audience and I can see a few people shaking their heads. Do you want to have a little think about this?
So look. Oh, okay, yeah. top left, please.
Top left. I gave you a chance there because I realised I put you under pressure. Don't feel bad because I think about a quarter of the people I play against usually don't spot the diagonals. This is where I normally win, but I thought I'd be fair and give you one chance to change your mind. So well spotted. Oh, I better block you just there. And that leaves just one cross left. Where would you like to place that one?
Let's have a go. Oh, yes. So am I stymied here anyway? So middle right, please.
Middle right, oh, hence stopping me from winning on the last go there. So that leaves just top right for me, which is kind of a draw. Not the most exciting outcome, I realised. I think most of the outcomes in this are a draw. What I didn't mention is I played a game of this last night with my partner. Yeah, we've had a really exciting lockdown. It's actually on here. If I open this up, hopefully that should look familiar to all of you. But wait. There is something else that I didn't tell you about. There's something printed on the back of each of these squares. So if I take out the centre one, I think this one will make it the most obvious. That should look familiar to at least some of you, I would hope. I'm going to pop that back in the centre. If these go in exactly the right formation, it does create a picture. Now, you remember, Denise started, I think you started bottom left, Denise, and as a result, we've ended up in this formation out of 255,168 possibilities. Let's have a look at the picture we've created.
Very good.
Wonderful stuff. The applause is for you, Denise. And thank you, Denise, for helping me out with that. We're almost at the end of the break. But just to mention, there is one game that I'm often asked about, and that is the National Lottery. I've got some tickets here. People often ask me, can I tell them the lottery numbers? Of course I can't. If I could predict the lottery, as lovely as you all are, I wouldn't be working right now. But if I could, it might look something like this. Yes. Instant cash. I'm holding on to these until they eventually let us out of lockdown and I can spend it on something fun. But that is the end of my little piece. So it just remains for me to say thank you to all of you for being a lovely audience. And thank you to the West London Business Awards for inviting me along to entertain you. Good night.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Darren Delaney. Next up, a special message from former host of the WLB Awards and long-serving presenter of Blue Peter, Connie Huck.
Hello to everyone at the West London Business Awards. Seems like a lifetime ago that I was hosting the event in the flesh, in a room with people and no social distancing, but I hope it's all going okay remotely. I just wanted to say a huge congratulations to all the finalists and winners, and a huge thank you to business leaders, staff, customers, all the community for their contributions in this most difficult of times. Keep up the good work, guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back your hosts, Sarah Spateri, and first of all, Andrew Dakers.
Hello again. Wasn't that brilliant? Thank you so much, Darren, for keeping us entertained. And thank you to Connie for your message of support. Now, we still have 14 awards to present, plus a number of special awards. So let's get going with four awards for sustainable and responsible business. And the first of these is the award for Apprentice of the Year. This award will be given to an apprentice who's made an exceptional contribution to the work of their West London employer. And this award will be presented by Sarah Spiteri.
Thank you, Andrew. Apprenticeships are a great way to take on young people and let them learn the skills you need for your teams to have for the future. The finalists in this category are Ala Canone. Ala is an electrical engineering apprentice at Openreach. His training provider was also Openreach. Yvette Smith. Yvette is a business administration apprentice at the Royal Marsden Hospital. Her training provider is Skills Training UK. Faraya Zafar. Faraya is a children and young people's workforce apprentice at Educare Family Support Service. Her training provider is Dynamic Training. Lily Rose John. Lily is a marketing apprentice at Cleveland's Diecast. Her training provider is JGA Group. Michael Westwood. Michael was an engineering apprentice and is now an engineering assistant at Reach Printing Services. His training provider was HCUC Apprenticeship and Skills. Sally Sturgis. Sally is a business administration apprentice at Anand Financial Architecture. Her training provider is HCUC Apprenticeships and Skills. And finally, Sunil Duggal. Sunil was a freight forwarding apprentice at DSV. His training provider was West Thames College. And the West London Apprentice of the Year 2021 is Lily Rose John.
Lily is a marketing apprentice at Cleveland's Diecast, one of the UK's largest wholesalers of model cars, planes, soldiers and the like. She's had a lot thrown at her. Her first apprenticeship provider went out of business. Then the lockdown meant she couldn't leave her home, and she's had little or no budget to work with. But that hasn't stopped her. Showing tremendous initiative, she's used free tools for her phone to lead new marketing campaigns across retail and wholesale websites. And she's created a website which will soon become a live retail platform for model cars from the movies. Cleveland says she's conscientious, positive and determined. In more ways than one, Lily is a model apprentice.
Congratulations, Lily. Now, our judges were so impressed by the standard of entries for this award that they've decided to award all six of our other finalists highly commended status.
Those congratulations to Ala Canone, Yvette Smith, Maria Zafar, Michael Westwood, Sally Sturgis and Sunil Duggal. Our judges thought all of you were shining examples of apprenticeships that have worked for you and your employers. And that's why you're all highly commended. Congratulations.
Well done to all our apprentices in such a competitive category. Next up is our Community Investment Award. This award was one of our most hotly contested this year. It will be presented by Katie Weil, General Manager of Westfield London.
Thank you, Andrew. Westfield are delighted to be sponsoring this award, which recognises the many businesses and other organisations doing outstanding work in our West London communities. I pay tribute to all of those businesses and individuals contributing to community cohesion and supporting the vulnerable at this most difficult of times. The finalists in this category are Action West London, the Children's Book Project, Hammersmith Bid Small Tap Big Change, Hammersmith Bid Made in Hammersmith and Fulham, HKS Architects, and Kailu. And we have a highly commended award to present for this category, and it goes to the Children's Book Project.
The Children's Book Project works across London, but especially in the West, to redistribute books to children and their families, targeting disadvantaged and book-poor communities. Last year, over 100,000 books were donated, and during lockdown they kept going, working with teachers to deliver 62,000 books to children in their homes. No need to read between the lines, this is a great project to spread the word about.
Well done to the Children's Book Project. And the winner of the West London Community Investment Award 2021 is HKS Architect.
HKS is an international design firm with a substantial presence in West London. They're working with London charity Blueprint, founded in memory of teenager Stephen Lawrence, an aspiring architect himself, which helps young people with disadvantaged backgrounds pursue the career they want. Specifically, they've organised a three-year architecture programme with presentations, workshops, inspirational talks. Our judges were especially impressed that all senior staff take part in one-to-one mentoring sessions with students on the programme. With strong sponsorship like this, these architects showing their commitment to building diversity, to building design.
Brilliant to see there's some cocktail mixing going on at HKS Architects, getting in the spirit of the evening. Now, of course, it's time to present the award for Green Circular Economy Business of the Year. And this award will be presented by Seema Mal Hotra, Member of Parliament for Feltham and Heston.
Thank you, Andrew. And I pay tribute to all the businesses nominated for awards tonight. There is more than one global crisis facing us today. And amid the pandemic, we must not lose sight of the urgent need for action on climate change. So I'm delighted to be presenting this award, which will go to a company in any sector taking initiatives to transform their business model into a circular approach, minimizing their environmental impact. The finalists in this category are EnviroBuild, Envopap, Horizon Insects, Ripe Office, Spruce, and the Felix Project. The West London Green Circular Economy Business of the Year 2021 is EnviroBuild.
EnviroBuild sells sustainable building materials. Since 2016, they've prevented over 2,500 tonnes of wood from being wasted and saved the equivalent of more than 120 million plastic bottles from landfill by using recycled materials. Within their supply chain, all packaging used is recycled and recyclable. All IT and office equipment is second-hand. 10% of their profits go to green causes. Circularity has been thoroughly integrated from start to finish, said our judges, noting that the company's clear purpose has helped their growth. For EnviroBuild, green definitely means go.
At last, we have a family pet joining the production. wonderful to see. Congratulations to EnviroBuild. Next, we have Responsible Workplace Award. This award will be presented by Munira Wilson, Member of Parliament for Twickenham.
Thank you, Andrew. The West London Business Awards show off the very best of local business. And this award recognises the very best practice in how local businesses support and treat their employees. The finalists in this category are Alexander's Removals, Chiswick Park Enjoy Work, Feed Factors Limited, Sahan Cares. And the winner of the West London Responsible Workplace Award 2021 is Chiswick Park Enjoy Work.
Enjoy yourself, it's later than you think. Enjoy yourself.
Chiswick Park is home to some of the world's leading companies. Enjoy work at the property management company, keeping it secure, clean and safe, and the people who work there engaged and enthused. They believe that if people enjoy work, they do better work, and this carries through to their own staff with a range of initiatives to promote development, reward good service and enable flexible working. Our judges particularly liked their Three Shining Stars Ambassadors scheme. Now, Enjoy Work can enjoy their moment in our awards spotlight.
Well done to Enjoy Work, clearly enjoying themselves there. So, 17 awards presented. We're about halfway through our evening. There's plenty more to come, though. Our awards for economic resilience, our individual leadership awards, our West London trivia game, more entertainment from the London College of Music, and, of course, we'll find out who is the West London Company of the Year 2021. We're going to take a short interval right now, but don't go far, and we'll be back with more awards in about 5 minutes' time.
This hit that ice cold, Michelle fight for that white gold. This one for them hood girls and good girls, straight masterpiece, styling, wildin', living it up in the city. Gonna chuck song with Saint Laurent, I'm gonna kiss myself, I'm so pretty. Too hot. Got the police and the fireman, I'm too hot. Gonna drag them all to retirement, I'm too hot. Say my name, you know who I am, too hot. And I'm all about that money, break it down. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Is Uptown Funk gonna give it to ya? Is Uptown Funk gonna give it to ya? Uptown Funk gonna give it to ya? Saturday night and we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. And stop, wait a minute. Pass my cup, put some liquor in it. Take a sip, sign a check. Coolio, get the stretch. Drive to Harlem, Hollywood, Jackson, Mississippi. Gonna show up, we're gonna show them out. Smoother than a fresh old tippy. Too hot. Got the police and the fireman, I'm too hot. Gonna drag them all to retirement, I'm too hot. Say my name, you know who I am, too hot. And I'm all about that money, break it down. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk gonna give it to ya. Uptown Funk gonna give it to ya. Uptown Funk gonna give it to ya. Saturday night and we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. Uptown funk you up, set a uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up, set a uptown funk you up. Uptown funk you up, set a uptown funk you up. And uptown funk you up, set a uptown funk you up. And dance, jump on it. If you're sexy, then flaunt it. If you're groovy, then own it. Don't brag about it, just show me. Dance, jump on it. If you're sexy, then flaunt it. And it's Saturday night and we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch. 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 Don't believe me, just watch.
Don't believe me, just watch. Hey, 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 oh!